Esta historia comienza en la parte más alta de un edificio. A lo lejos se ve un volcán y arriba la luna. Dos amigas platican sobre el cielo, comparten un té y hablan del cosmos.
¿A dónde se va la memoria de lo que hemos vivido? La guardan el aire, el cielo y las rocas.
Las rocas guardan el conocimiento del tiempo, de un tiempo anterior al que cada una de nosotras puede recordar, anterior al nacimiento de nuestros propios abuelos, un tiempo extendido en millones de años y que vino incluso antes de la Tierra. Una meteorita nos platicó sobre el reloj del universo, nos contó el secreto del tiempo, la edad del Sol y la edad de la Tierra.
Nos acercamos a la meteorita como a una biblioteca que flota en el espacio, esperando que dos amigas decidieran consultarla para después compartir su memoria geológica.
Todos los motores corriendo. Copiamos 0165 altura confirmada. Misión. Confirmamos misión. Avance. Copiamos. Altitud 145.77. Misión control. Estamos muy emocionadas. Comenzamos avance. Reportando visibilidad dentro de la cabina. Primer acercamiento. Objeto localizado.
20 grados, 28 minutos, 25 segundos norte.
103 grados, 26 minutos, 35 segundos oeste. Nombre clave, Tlajomulco. Nombre clave, Tlajomulco.
Bibliotecas del Espacio is an experimental educational platform that uses multidisciplinary practices to create an horizontal way for sharing knowledge into the community, such as art, writing, and planetary sciences.
Este pequeño amiguito que tiene Shelhad en sus manos es un meteorito que se llama Punta de Cielo y es un meteorito metálico.
So far, we have developed two projects. Las rocas nos cuentan cosas and Travesía Estelar in three different communities for specific populations.
Bueno, este es el mío. ¿Cuál es más grande?
¿El negro o el amarillo?
Amarillo. Ok, ahora fíjense si hago yo esto. ¿Cuál es más grande?
Las rocas nos cuentan cosas. It's a creative writing and meteorites workshop for children and elderly. Together, we study space rocks, talk about the solar system and our own experiences with the sky.
Estaba en la terraza enfrente de mi casa, mirando el cielo y las figuras de las nubes, cuando de repente vi algo cayendo hacia mi casa. Era muy reluciente y rápida. Era mediana, no muy grande. Cayó en el patio y fui corriendo, la agarré y la guardé. Y es mi supernova meteorito más preciado.
On the other hand, taking into account the Women and Girls Science World Day, we designed Travesía Estelar, a face-to-face workshop for girls between 8 and 11 years old, where, by the companion of women scientists, thinkers, and observers of the sky, we recreate an analog space mission to discover together how to do science as a team. Our headquarters was Biblioteca Los Mangos in Puerto Vallarta, Jalisco, with an attendance of 15 girls. During the 3 days of the workshop, we gathered around thinking about the space science from its female representatives, also taking care of our own curiosity, conducting team research.
Our approach is interdisciplinary. The activities contemplate methodological strategies very close to those of science: observation, experimentation, verification, and socialization based on creativity exercises from different artistic manifestations. For las rocas nos cuentan cosas. We chose creative writing as an instrument because it allows us to recognize ourselves, to know that our voice matters, our way of observing the world, establishing relationships with what surrounds us, and asking ourselves questions about the sky. And for Travesía Estelar, we chose the space analog mission as a strategy in which teamwork and the possibility of exploring our environment allows us to approach science in friendlier ways. We consider multidisciplinary work as a communication channel open to generating richer networks and dialogues between science and the public. We believe that the engine of both art and science is curiosity, and we take advantage of that meeting point to share it with our communities. From these collaborative networks between diverse communities and disciplines, we understand more deeply the importance of sharing and exchanging knowledge, so that we can communicate and learn from the public.
Mi nombre es Regina, tengo 5. La cosa que me gustan de los meteoritos es de que tienen un color diferente. Morado, azul, gris, café y ya.
At the end of the workshops, we collected the text created during the sessions and asked the participants to share with us by reading their own writings. In some of the headquarters, we had support for the recording of the text, respecting the security measures during the contingency. And those who could not go to the headquarters were offered guide so they themselves could share their own sound recordings. With this sound file, we made 3 sound pieces using the radio storytelling structure. These were played through mobile speakers around the neighborhoods where the workshops were held. A fundamental part of our project is the oral tradition and the importance of the voices of those who participate in the workshops. Their texts and thoughts remain as an historical memory of each local community.
Regina is 5 years old and already knows how to identify a meteorite. 85-year-old Marta shares with us the name that her grandfather gave to the stars. And just like them, who participated in the workshop, little by little, we shed the weight of considering science as something distant and difficult. We all listen to each other. We speak, we write, adding new knowledge. But most important, we learn to love and care about the sky.
Dos amigas decidieran consultarla para después compartir su memoria geológica.
Todos los motores corriendo. Copiamos 0165 altura confirmada. Misión. Confirmamos misión. Avance. Copiamos. Altitud 145.77. Misión control. Estamos muy emocionadas. Comenzamos avance. Reportando visibilidad dentro de la cabina. Primer acercamiento. Objeto localizado
20 grados 28 minutos 25 segundos norte.
103 grados 26 minutos 35 segundos oeste. Nombre clave Tlajomulco. Nombre clave Tlajomulco.